Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the very first video of me flying the OH-58D module. I have literally not flown a single second in this helicopter. This will be my very first flight, and I have only just set up my axis, my collective anti-torque and cyclic. I may have to go in and adjust the axis a bit, because sometimes it is inverted, sometimes it's not. It is very confusing, and I don't know why Eagle Dynamics made it like that, or the module developer. So I have not flown a single second in this helicopter, so if I'm a bit all over the place, you know why. Yeah, this is the built-in Caucasus free flight mission, and it does not seem like the engines are running, although all the systems are. The torque is up, but the rotor blade does not seem to be spinning. And if you look at the rotor blade going this way. That means that when I rate the collective, the helicopter will go the opposite way. The rotor spins to the left, therefore the helicopter will turn to the right. And I need to counter that with anti-torque pedals. That is just about the only thing I know. and I also mapped the trimmer and reset trim button. No other buttons have been mapped. And let's go to axis. This is collective. I guess I need to invert that. And the throttle, I do not know. Yeah, I need to invert that also, I believe. Anti-torque pedals, cyclic is fine, okay. Full throttle. Okay, track IR have been reset, slowly erasing the collective, and I'm looking at my torque meter, that is the number 26, that is 26% torque, and I need to know that's my airspeed, slowly erasing the collective, it is going up. The helicopter is turning to the right, the opposite way of the rotor spinning. That is correct. A bit more collective. A bit more. I'm inside ground effect. So. Just holding the collective, using the cyclic to maintain a somewhat hover. Okay, forward a little bit, more collective. Do a little bit of turn, lower the collective. trying to stop her and go into a transition to hover. I need to be very careful with my VRS now. Bit more collective. Bit more. Okay, not that much engine power. Let's go for a short flight. Trying to use the trim. Whoop. I forgot to set the trim function in the settings. I prefer the reset to center trim. She did not react to my... I was reading the collective, but not much happened. But the torque meter went up, but it, like, she didn't respond to the raising the collective. Let's try that again. Is my collective fully calibrated in Verpal software? I do not know. And I... Let's try this. Let's try calibrating it again, just to make sure. Throttle. Save calibration to profile. Save profile. And then switch back to DCS. Done. Let's try the fourth trim. Let's go for a flight among the trees. She is not very twitchy, and she is not very calm. It is hard to explain, but you're treating her with respect, because you know, if you just make a sudden movement, she will bang over or descend very quickly. So it feels like you are walking on eggshells with her. Let's try to transition to hover. She starts to dropping, and this is where I'm finding it hard to keep her level, despite me increasing the collective. I would say that the Mi-8 is much easier. But it is not that hard. I just need to know her better. Because it is not that hard, but yeah, you need to respect her. So, let's back to forward flight. She reacts pretty effective on the collective inputs. When I lower my collective, the nose turns to the left, and I need to counter that with my anti-torque pedal. Let's see how. Oh, she's dropping. When I'm doing a turn, she drops. Oh! She was about to roll over. So, yeah. Transition to hover. Actually, pretty good effect on my anti-torque pedals to counter the rotor. Actually, not that hard to get into a hover. Let's try it forward again. She drops very easily and in the turns. Yeah, you need to be pretty active on your anti-torque pedals when you're using your collector. It is actually very satisfying to use your right hand, your left hand, left foot, right foot, and your eyes and your ears. That's why I like helicopters. They are so lively, and you're all the way down here in the dirt below treetop. Moving in and out of trees and along pathways, and it is just so nice. I love helicopters. Oh, and the rotor slap. She is very, very quick to stop. That was very easy. Very nice with the audible warning, torque warning. Because my eyes is not on that. My eyes are on outside the cockpit. So the audible warning is very nice, and my chair is sliding backwards. I actually got a brand new chair today, a Secret Lab Titan Evo Lite. So let's land, and I guess that's it. Let's land down here. Wow, that was easy. That was surprisingly easy. Well, that was actually pretty nice. I'm missing some response on my collective. I don't know if it is the way I'm flying, or that is just the way the helicopter is, but the Mi 8 and the Car 50 has much better instant and one-to-one reaction to my collective. The collective response is almost the same from the very button to the very top of my collective range. The collective response does not change in the Mi 8 and Car 50. Here it is dynamic. It is changing depending on my flight regime. So I need to learn that, because I think that this helicopter is extremely nice. I would be very satisfied flying in her. The automation and gadget level are just enough. It is not a tablet with the gas turbine on, and it is not 1950s. So the initial response is that when I learn to respect her, learn her ways of doing things, I believe I will be very happy flying her. So yeah, that was my very first flight. So yeah, my first 10 minutes in this flight, yeah. And I crashed into the last flight. So thank you for watching, and I'll be flying a lot more to know her, doing a lot of just free flight, flying among the trees and so on, not so action-packed flight, because I want to know how to fly her before I want to know how to fight with her. So aviation is much more important to me. So yeah, thank you for watching, and have a nice day. Oh yeah, since I'm using AMD software, whenever it is hard to explain, but when I was flying her, that is like one screen, and then this debriefing screen is outside of the flying, therefore AMD does not know how to stop recording. So I need to quit DCS, then stop the recording, because AMD is AMD is AMD. There's a reason why it is cheaper than Nvidia. Enough said.